Hey everyone, Matthew Valente here to show you this awesome new synth from Plogue called ChipSynth OPS-7. It's a bit accurate recreation of the six operator legend, the Yamaha DX7. You can expect nothing less than extreme accuracy and passion from Plogue. They do their research and ensure that you get one of the best, easiest experiences you can. It's like having that amazing synthesizer in your computer. Now I know you're thinking that this kind of synth has been done before, but Plogue is passionate about emulation, delivering a sound that would make you not tell the difference between actual hardware and software. Everything from low and high-pitched aliasing to the limitations of the synthesizer. The Yamaha DX7 really changed the game back in the 80s. It was a pretty complex piece of hardware. One of the things about it was that it had a huge learning curve. The cool thing about OPS-7 is that it's incredibly easy to use once you get used to the interface. If you've used past chip synths, you're already trained. With OPS-7, you don't have to go through submenus with a tiny LCD display to get the most out of this FM synthesizer, as all the options are right in front of you. Alright, so I'm going to go over the layout of this new synth. This will have a lot of options, so I'll try to best explain it without going on too long about something that should be self-explanatory. That being said, it is advised for you to go through the manual just to double check if you're not sure about how some of the settings work. Though if you're familiar with ChipSynth MD, a lot of these layouts may look familiar, though there are some differences. So the first option we have is the presets dropdown. This is where you can save your global patch settings as well as your configuration in the settings pop-up window. If you like your VST to pop up at a certain zoom level by default, you can save your default settings here. Then we have the view tabs. They're the way OPS-7 divides the views. Layer A is your first patch, layer B is your second. They can be completely different settings in layer A, like a Crystal Rhodes piano, for example, than what might be in layer B, perhaps a polysynth sound. SYX, or 6, is kind of like your patch library. For the sake of this video, I think I'm just going to keep calling it SYX. In here, you can store up to 32 patches per layer, just like the original hardware. You can even import SYX files from either your actual DX7 or just SYX files you've downloaded from the internet. If you're familiar with how in-depth I got with ChipSynth SFC, then you'll know what the Matrix tab is. So in this case, Plogue has merged the Matrix and Steps tabs together to save space. We'll talk more about this later in the video. The FX tab was never used in ChipSynth SFC, but it is a staple in both ChipSynth Porta FM and MD. It's where you can set your effects such as delay, reverb, chorus. You can even utilize an arpeggiator. Okay, let's start with the layer tabs. A and B are stacked to play at the same time by default. If you decide you don't want a certain layer to play, you can disable or enable the layer with the beige button at the top left. The panel at the top left is your main patch settings. Here you can change things such as your patch's volume, default panning, etc. You can even name the patch and it'll save in your SYX tab. A lot of other functions pertain to settings you'd mostly find in Plogue's other FM synthesizers. Things like randomizing the patch and seeing if you can make something completely new by chance. You can also change the algorithm of your operators on the fly, setting up your pitch bend ranges, or limit the range of the patches with low key and high key so you can set up instrument splits. There are options for portamento, glissando, and new in OPS-7 is the ability to quickly duplicate your patch onto the second layer, which makes creating detuned patches extremely easy. Another way to detune the layers between each other is the A-B detune knob at the top, which will take the A and the B tab and change the fine pitch between them to make a sort of chorused effect between the two. The two don't have to be the same patch. This is a very common technique chip artists will do to make a sort of flanging style effect. Okay, now that we have the basic patch settings covered, the middle section is the algorithm layout. The DX7 made figuring out algorithm a bit complicated because you had to refer to a little diagram at the top of the DX7 to see exactly how your operators were modulating each other. You had to change these settings with a tiny LCD screen in the middle of the unit. As you can see, ChipSynth OPS-7 makes this a lot easier. There's also a default pitch envelope and LFO modulation panel. If you click on one, it brings the operator into focus at the top right panel. And here you get to fine-tune all the settings of the operator you're setting up. You can set the level, velocity sensitivity, tremolo, Set how much the settings are affected depending on where you are on the keyboard. You can calibrate it with the breakpoint settings as well as changing the scale curve. You can also tune the operators and even detune them. This already shows how much more powerful the OPS chip was compared to what came before it. Next is the envelope section. R and L1 to 4 pertain to different envelope settings. It's best to check the manual for exact functions here, but you can think of the R's as attack, decay, sustain, release, time lengths, and the L's as amplitude levels for each of them. The graph on the screen will show you what I mean. As an alternative to clicking on the desired operator, you can also click on the header of the top right panel and choose which operator you want to see. You can also select the pitch envelope LFO settings to get a more detailed view of the vibrato that you're setting up for your patch. Now you have quite possibly one of the coolest menus of this new plugin. The tab named SYX or 6 is short for SysX, which in itself is short for System Exclusive. System exclusives are commands that MIDI devices used to use to send messages to the hardware to change some of the more advanced functions of the unit, or even just to save the configuration to use at a later time. This is the primary function of this menu. People have been sharing their DX, SysX, Banks files for decades, and you guessed it, OPS 7 can load these saved patches. The screen can look a little daunting and confusing, but think of it as three main columns. The first one is where you can load your SysX bank files. When you click on an SYX file, you can then see the patches within the bank in the file list. Then, the second major column, the AB layer columns, will have your patches so that you can use them in your OPS 7 preset. Copy any patch you want from SYX to your own, or save your own SYX patches from here. Want to copy all the original DX7 bank A and B commercial factory presets? Easy. Just highlight them all and drag them in. The patch can be changed with your MIDI program change settings within your sequencer, as long as you didn't disable it within the settings menu at the top. You can also copy patches from column A to column B just by dragging them over. This is another way you can make a detuned stack. Now the next major panel is something you've probably been wondering about. David from Plug has just released an amazing video that shows how you can import, export, and synchronize your patches between your real DX7 and OPS7. He goes over configuring and syncing both to be as accurate to each other as possible, even going through the intricacies of how to set OPS7 to match the aliasing and the tiny little nuances that each individual DX7 has through its DAC and other things such as filters. Any past ChipSynth user will recognize the Matrix menu as well. Even if you didn't use it, if you peeked at some of the presets, you'll know that the Matrix and the Step menus are the heart of some of the incredibly complex sounds created with every version of ChipSynth. In this menu, you can set up automation for almost every knob in the AB Layers tab, whether it's setting up traditional general MIDI modulation on controller 1, or setting up a complex LFO modulator to modulate algorithm changes mid-song. It's all here. The Matrix tab can be extremely complicated to use. I won't get into detail about how to use it here. However, I have a video on my own channel that shows the intricacies of setting up the Matrix and the step tabs for ChipSynth SFC, and the concept is exactly the same here. The effects tab is where you can really flesh out some of the sounds, with effects such as arpeggios, chorus, reverb, and delay. These are the kinds of effects that really add life to your sound. Unfortunately, none of the effects can be modulated with the Matrix. OPS 7 is fully NKS certified, which means you can load the plugin in complete control and utilize the controller's easy-to-use interface so you can set up favorite patches without even looking at your computer screen. So loading the plugin on the complete control is very simple. You just go to the browser button here. You can select any of your plugins. As you can see, I've got Chip Speech, I got ChipSynth MD. ChipSynth OPS 7, that's what we're going to be loading. So we just click load here, and now the plugin's loaded on the controller. As you can see, also the plugin is also loaded on the Complete Control VST host. And now we can go to the browser section and start loading some presets. Now, I don't think these are playing in real time. I think Complete Control just uses WAV files. It does give you a preview of the preset that you're loading here. I really like this bass sound, so I'm going to use this bass sound. So So now it's loaded into the plugin. As you can see, the operator's all changed. Maybe it's not thick enough. Let's try that one. You can hear the DAC, the low resolution DAC there with the fuzziness of the sound. Let's load that one actually. Listen to the crunch on that. If I don't like the sound of it, you can try changing the algorithm. Of course, the DX7 has, I think, 32 different kinds of algorithms. Listen to that. I love that sound. Kind of almost reminds me of Fantasia. Very Rhodesy sound. Wow, what is that? What happens if I change that? Oh, it changes the brightness of it. Ooh, a cowbell. Ooh, that sounds familiar, doesn't it? Kind of a recreation of the famous Crystal Rhodes from the DX7. The other cool thing is you can set ChipSynth OPS7 to have custom matrix settings for the specific controller, and then you can assign those controllers here.
Well, that's it for me today. Please have some fun with this. Don't hesitate to post your amazing creations on social media. Plogue loves seeing what amazing creations people have made with their software. Until next time. Whether you're making something old or making something new, OPS7 has you covered for any of your FM needs.